guys, I am going on holiday. I don't know if I've mentioned it, probably loads, but by the time you see this, I will already be on holiday. I thought I would share my makeup and toiletries. I was gonna do travel makeup and do a bit of a get ready with me, but I think what I'm gonna try and do is film a couple of get ready movies while I'm in Las Vegas. So we'll see, but if I remember correctly, the room we're gonna be in is pretty good lighting wise, but very least a daytime look like I'm wearing right now. But I'm gonna run you through everything I'm taking. I thought if I did this as two separate videos, it might be a bit dull. But there's a lot of stuff I've got laid out on the bed. So I'm gonna run you through everything I'm taking makeup-wise, then I'll get into kind of toiletries on my carry-on and the rest of the stuff. So first and foremost, I have, I feel, covered all bases that I possibly could want to without overpacking. I mean, this is probably more makeup than I'm gonna use or need, but I still feel like this is kind of condensed. So what I'm wearing right now, which I think is probably going to be what I'll wear on the regular, is Revlon Colorstay. The colour that I've got is sand beige, and I've got a little bit of colour finally actually matches me. I'm wearing the Instant Age Rewind Dark Circle Treatment, which is the very, very pale pink that I believe is only available in the US, but I will link to an Amazon seller. I love this stuff. I just do that whole triangle thing and like blend it out. It is very, very light. If you like the original, it's a very, very similar formula, but it's really brightening. That's all I've got under my eyes. I'm also taking the Nars Radiant Creamy Concealer in case I need a little bit of heavier coverage. Right now I've got some kind of acne scarring down here and a little bit around here that's is kind of like sticking with me. So if I want to cover that up, or if I've got really, really bad dark circles, I'm taking that just in case, but honestly, I think this will be my base. Powder is the Vichy Dermablend. I use this in my drugstore versus high-end, or whatever I call it, high street versus high-end makeup last week. Love this stuff so much. It is pretty good when it comes to oil control, but everything is blurred and beautiful. I think it's about £14. The amount that you get and how long this is going to last, I actually don't think that's a bad price. I would highly, highly recommend this. It can look a little bit powdery at first, but especially if you are on the oilier side, I think you will love it. I am taking four cheek products, which may seem excessive. One of them is a bronzer. I found this little mini Hoola. I don't know where I got this from. It must have been in a gift set. So I'm taking that as my bronzer. I am taking one regular blush, which is this Nars Sex Appeal. That's not going to show up the colour, is it? Because I feel like it's really bleached out. That's a bit better. Nars Sex Appeal, which is this beautiful kind of corally pink. It's a warm pink, but it's a totally matte color and really, really nice if you're very heavy-handed and tend to do that whole babushka cheeks that I do. So I love that one, and it looks really nice with a tan, just as it does on pale skin. So I'm taking that in case I want it, but I think I'm probably going to wear this every single day, and this is MAC Stereo Rose, my all-time favorite my all-time favorite blusher. And I'm actually kind of, it's a flat pan now, guys. This is probably as close to hitting pan on a blush as I've ever got. I'm getting a little bit concerned about it. I love it so much. I don't know if the glow, I think you can see that. I love it, I just love it. It's a beautiful sheen, just a little bit of kind of a corally golden color. It is perfect for holidays, but it's my all-time favorite blush. And I don't even think it is a permanent thing. I think it's temporary or a limited edition. So when it comes back, and I know every time it comes back, it's slightly different. I would imagine it's very difficult to make it the same every time, but I will be purchasing it again. And I may try some more of the MAC skin finish things that they've got, because I love, it's just the finish, I think. I don't think it's necessarily the color, it's the finish. Then I've got my Becca bronzer in Champagne Pop, which I don't know whether or not I'm going to end up using this, because this is kind of as highlighted as I want to be, but I'm taking it in case I want to do the bronzer and the other blush. I also really want to try this Becca highlight in a different colour. While I'm there, I want to pick up a paler one. I've been told opal might be right for my regularly pale skin. Then I'm taking my Helen Stage eyeshadow primer and two palettes, but they're little ones and not that dissimilar, but hey, I'm doing it anyway. This was the alternate, and it's so thin, I just thought I'm throwing it in. So there's Naked Basics, this is the original Naked Basics, and the six pan MAC. I did a video on these actually, I'll link it below, on all my MAC palettes, and then this particular six one that I've made for kind of spring summer. So I'm taking that one as well. That's got kind of some shimmery, some to do some little options colour wise. But I think that's probably as much as I'm going to need. I'm not going to do anything really, really dark and smoky. I have two kinds of eyeliner. So I've got my Balm Schwing liquid liner and the Urban Decay Zero Glide On 24/7 pencil thing. My mascara is the Volume Million Fatale Lashes. This is basically a like favourites of favourites, isn't it, when you do travel makeup? Because it's the stuff that I absolutely love so much that these are the things. This is the creme de la creme of my makeup stash. Then I've got two different brow products. What I'm wearing right now is the Benefit Gimme Brow, and this is the one that I think I'm going to be reaching for most often. However, in the evening, because Vegas is kind of a holiday of two halves, in the evening, if I want to go a little bit more bold with my eye makeup, I never feel like this is quite enough. I want a bolder brow. And so I've got the KaBrow, which is like a gel cream colour. This, in theory, if you see the colour of it, you'd think that was nowhere near dark enough for my brows. But I do find, especially if you're going to wear a heavier brow, if you go a little bit lighter than you think you would, like if you're too dark, it looks really, really harsh. If you go a little bit lighter, it works. Like this one is very, very dark, the Gimme Brow, probably darker than my natural hair. But because it gives you kind of a more natural, sparse brow look, it's not such a big deal. Whereas if I went as dark with the KaBrow, it would look like, you know, marker brows. So they are the two that I'm taking, and I think that leads us to lips. I'm taking the Nuxe Revdimil Stick Lip Balm. I've got like 14 different lip balms with me just in case. One in my handbag, this is going in my makeup bag, and another one's going in my carry-on little stash as well, because you cannot have enough lip balm in the desert. Lips, I've been really, this is where I normally cannot narrow it down. If you've seen my previous travel makeup bags, this is where I always fall down and I'm like, oh, I've done really well, but I'm taking 14 lipsticks. I'm taking two lip liners. I'm currently wearing the Charlotte Tilbury Litchi in Pillow Talk, and I'm wearing that on its own. I love this, really, really like it. I don't love the price, but I've used it so much, I would buy it again, and I haven't found one this color or this texture. If you're looking for the texture, but you're not bothered about the color, the Max Factor lip liners are fantastic. But this is exactly the colour. She was a bit of a genius when she created this, and I love it. So really, really would still recommend this despite the price. I've said in the past that I was like, eh, but no, I do love it. And I'm taking Dynamo from MAC, which is a really bright kind of, I don't even know what colour I would say. It's like a really, really warm, bright pink. And it will go with the two lipsticks that I'm taking. I'm taking MAC Faux, obviously. You haven't seen this before. All-time favourite lipstick. So that will go with my Charlotte Tilbury one. And then I've got these two from Nars, which look like this. And no, they're not the same. They're totally different, and it completely warrants taking both of them. This one is paler. This one is brighter. Need both of them, for sure. This one is Natalie, and this one is Grace. And I've been thinking of adding to my, these are the Audacious Nars lipsticks, thinking of adding to that collection because these are really, really nice as well. But I can't find colours that I like as much as these, so we'll see, maybe while I'm over there. So that is it for my makeup bag. No, it's not, two more things. Tweezers. Because left unchecked, I will have a full beard in a week. I swear to God, I, every few days, pluck the chin hairs, every few days. And at some point this week, I looked in the mirror and I swear to God, there were about 30 hairs that were visible, black and thick. It is horrifying. If you have this issue, you have all of my sympathy. It is the most irritating thing. I don't know what it is. I don't know if it's a hormonal imbalance. I don't know if I'm actually older than I'm saying that I am. I don't know what the situation is, but it's getting worse and worse all the time. And I think by this time next year, I'm going to be a full-on bearded lady. But yeah, tweezers at all times, because so many chin hairs. Only the occasional mustache situation, but chin, full on. So tweezers are absolutely essential. And this I just got in a little gift set, Clinique Pep Start Hydro Blur Moisturiser, and I used it before I put my makeup on today. And it's kind of like a strange hybrid between a moisturiser and like Perfection from Benefit, you know, like that kind of pore primer. Really interesting, because I don't love those pore primers because they feel really greasy and silicone-y. Never like totally sold on them, but this was some kind of weird hybrid. I really liked it, so I'm gonna take this to give it a go. I'm really interested to see whether or not it helps with the oiliness. So that is my makeup pack. I will talk a little bit about brushes, but I want to get into my carry-on stuff. For an annoying reason, I cannot find. I've got a little Ziploc plastic bag that I usually put this stuff in, and I cannot find it anywhere. So I'm just going to end up using like a proper Ziploc, like sandwich bag or something. I've got like a special fit for purpose one. I can't find it. So in my carry-on, I will have, and I have just pulled out one thing from my makeup bag to throw in here, that you will see again, but face wipes. These are Micellar Water Makeup Remover Wipes from Model Zone. Really quite liked these, but they're in a really handy pack, and that's the main reason that I'm packing them. So my makeup and stuff, all of that is now officially packed. When I finish this video, everything you see will be put in a case, and I am, why am I looking at my watch? That's a Peter Kay thing. I am 3 days away, or 2 days away from holiday. What is it, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday? Well, we go down to Gatwick on Friday, so 2 days away. And I'm not gonna be wearing any of my favorite makeup or any of my toiletries that I'm showing you at all until we actually get on holiday. So anything that I desperately needed or might need the morning of the flight or anything has to go in here. So everything else packed away. Number one, makeup wipes. So that will probably be how I remove my makeup on Friday night. Sorry. Number two, moisturizer. Now, I remember the last few times I went to Las Vegas, I used this Drink Up Intensive Overnight Mask from Origins, and I was so dry that I ended up using this every single night as my moisturizer, because it would just, as I put it on my face, it just immediately absorbed. So this is pretty much the only moisturiser that I'm taking. I will tell a little bit more about that in my toiletries, but this is the main one, and I'm putting that straight in my carry-on. I've also got this Pepstar eye cream, because I'm not sold on any one eye cream at the moment, and again, I got a little Clinique gift set, and I bought some stuff recently, and this was a little mini eye cream, so if you can't see that because it's so far away, looked pretty cute, so I'm going to throw that in there as well. This from Embryolisse, is the Secret. Hang on a minute, is it on the other side? Artist's Secret. I got caught in that trap before, trying to speak the French. It's like, do you remember Forehead? I don't remember if I've mentioned this in a video before, but I know I've made this analogy, but maybe it was on my blog. So if you remember Forehead, this is a very, very similar kind of concept. You take the lid off and hope the thing doesn't fall out, because I have melted it a little bit and I've not got very much left of it at all. And you basically just kind of dab it underneath your eye, and it's a really amazing cooling sensation. Not dissimilar to Forehead, like 4-H-E-A-D. Anyone remember this? It's like a non-medicinal headache treatment. Really good for kids, and if you've had like a million ibuprofen and nothing's working and you don't feel like you can take any more for fear of an overdose, Forehead is fantastic. And as a kid, I suffered so many headaches, so it was a thing. Nearly dropped that. I was very familiar with. This is really, really similar. So you put it under your eyes, very, very cooling, feels refreshing, really nice. So I'm taking that with me on the plane. I'm always thinking kind of hydration in eyes. I have this lip balm, which is the Lip Essence from Paul and Joe. I got this in the advent calendar. This is lovely. Very, very thick and gloopy. I seem to remember it smelling really nice, but I can't quite get the scent from it now. Really, really thick. And one of the things, especially on an aeroplane, you get really dry and you feel just like all of the moisture has been sapped from your skin. So that is the lip balm I decided to take on the plane with me. I have got the Caudalie Beauty Elixir, which has got alcohol in it and kind of is counterintuitive when it comes to that. But again, a bit refreshing. So towards the end, when I want to freshen up, I'll go take the wipes, freshen up with this, and I have a little bit of makeup to apply on the plane if I want to. But very, very minimal. I have been known to take face masks, all kind of stuff, and I don't really use any of it. And so morning of, I won't be wearing any makeup. I'll get on the flight and then I'll put on my Origins stuff, maybe a little bit of eye cream. Towards the end of the flight, then I'll put on a little bit of makeup just so I feel a bit human again when I actually get off and start my holiday. But I haven't overpacked, which I feel like normally I do. So I have this little mini of the That Gal Brightening Face Primer from Benefit. A lot of this has just been because I've got miniatures of things. I had a mini of the Naked Skin from Urban Decay. So this is a little concealer. Then I've got a mini of the Benefit They're Real. That's my mascara. I've got a mini Sugar Berry Lip Balm from Fresh, which is like a kind of like a tinted lip balm. It smells amazing. I have the perfume of this, the Sugar Fresh perfume. Oh, smells awesome. Then I have put my Gimme brow from Benefit in here as well, because it's petite, but also I feel like I'm not myself without my brows. So needed a little bit of that. The other thing that I've got in this, which is a bit of a wild card, is the Sally Hansen Gel Cuticle Remover. And the reason that I've got this in here is because I don't often, especially while I'm on holiday, I'm not gonna have the time necessarily, but I don't often have the time to sit and let a cuticle remover kind of do its thing and really kind of massage everything in. And so I'm taking this with me, and I think, actually now I'm thinking about it, I'm gonna take a little oil as well, so I can give myself a little nail treat while I'm on the plane. So that is everything. It's not actually that much stuff. It usually take loads more in my carry-on, so I'm pretty happy with that as a condensed little bag of stuff. Okay, regular toiletries. So, hair. I'm taking a hairbrush, but I'm not sure what hairbrush yet, so this is not in here, but otherwise, not a lot for hair. I've got the Philip Kingsley Elasticizer, which previously I've said I don't really like, but that's because I don't really think it does anything for very, very damaged hair. If you've got slightly dry ends, like my hair is in pretty good condition these days, and the very, very ends where I've still got some color and or bleach from a long time ago, and they're obviously the ends, they could do with a little bit of a treat occasionally, and I feel like now this is coming into its own. I'm putting a little bit of this on the ends of it overnight and my hair feels absolutely amazing, but it doesn't need to go anywhere near my roots. And if your hair is really damaged, I don't feel like this will touch it. Right now, loving it. So especially because I'm gonna be in the sun and in the pool and stuff, I thought I would take this with me. Then I've got Head & Shoulders Apple Fresh, because it's my favorite. And we've got the bigger one because we'll both be using it and we'll probably use this up over the course of the week because I wash my hair every day and so does he. Not taking any dry shampoo, because these days my hair dries pretty quickly and I just kind of leave it to do what it's going to do. I'm not going to take any hair tools at all. So just this, and then my 3-Minute Miracle Reconstructor for a little bit of moisture on the ends of my hair. I feel like I'm not going to be able to get away without any kind of conditioner in the desert. So that is kind of it. Very, very basic on the hair care front. Oh, I've just remembered as well, Lee's taking a little mini, because most of this is his toiletries as well. Lee's taking a little mini hair paste thing, a wax thing. And obviously we'll take some razors, but that's kind of the only things that I think I've forgotten here. We've got some travel toothbrushes and little toothpaste. For the rest of, oh, and we're also taking kind of a full-size deodorant, because we'll share that too. Hello? I have no idea what we got up to, because I've just been interrupted like 50 times, and I've got a friend waiting for me downstairs now. So, let's get on with it. The rest of my toiletries. So, I got the only mask of any kind, I think. God, I'm out of breath now. I only run up the stairs. That's pretty terrible, isn't it? So, the only mask I'm taking. Dark Circle Reducer Minimizing Patches. I have spoken about these a lot. I love them so much, and I can hardly ever find them in Boots. But they are like hydrogel things, but they've got like a material on the outside. So they're just really comfortable to wear, and you're not going to get them. They're not sticky on the outside or anything. Just really awesome. I wear them overnight. They really, really help my pigmentation that I've got around my eyes. People have mentioned that recently, and I definitely attribute this to how well that's faded. Now, they'll probably come back worse in the summer, as they always do, but I will buy these in bulk because I love them so much. They also are very cooling and just generally hydrate that area, I think, and make my fine lines appear a little bit reduced, but I don't think they do anything for darker circles, so that's what you're buying it for. Maybe not great, but I've found different benefits, and I love them still. So I'm taking these, because at some point during the trip, my eyes are gonna be like, can't open. But I'm only taking one packet because they are rationed in my house. For makeup removal and just general cleansing, I don't have any miniatures of anything. I'm not really totally sold on any one thing as like a must have at the moment. However, I might buy some stuff while I'm over there. So I'm taking some stuff, may replace it while I'm there. I've got the Clinique Take Off The Day makeup remover and the Rinse Off Foaming Cleanser. So I'm gonna use this basically as my double cleanse. We'll see. For other skincare, this is a little depotted. I tried to clean this bottle, right? It's covered in bits now because it's sticky. This is a Body Shop shower gel bottle, and I tried to clean it with boiling hot water, and stupidly, why would I not think of it melting? It like warped the whole bottle, so it's got like a weird nipple at the bottom of it now, and it doesn't stand normal. But it still holds the liquid. So this is the Garnier Clarifying Tonic, because if I don't use this, I break out. I spottily used this over the past couple of weeks. I have had breakouts and I'm like, ugh, killing myself over it. So I'm taking this with me because I cannot risk full-on breakouts on holiday. So that's a miniature of that that I have created. I will then have my Origins moisture mask thing, but I'm going to take this Avène Hydrating Serum. Yeah, that's probably English, isn't it? Hydrating Serum. Very, very lightweight. I can use this under my makeup or at night, depending on how my skin is feeling. I've got this La Roche-Posay Psychoplast Soothing Repair Balm. Absolutely amazing. Now, I don't know if you can tell, I've got a hilarious tan line here. I was sitting in the sun last week sometime and it's still sore because it's been a long time since I sat in the sun. Quite a while of cold winter weather. We had one day of sun. I was like, I'm gonna get a tan for my holiday. And I was very, very red, like fabulously when I took off my clothes. It was hilarious. So I used this and it's awesome. It just calms everything down. It's so soothing. You know, when you've got skin that you put a moisturizer on, it stings immediately. This is just so, so good. I've used it on so many different ailments. It's great for if you've got kids, like nappy rash and just various skin conditions that they could come up with, or really, really chapped lips or chapped skin. Really, really amazing. And we'll always, always have some in. And this is the miniature that I've got at the moment. So I've got a couple of these on the go, but this is the smallest tube. I'm taking it with me. I have a couple of moisturizers. The Shea Butter Body Butter, because I had a miniature of that, and it's a thick one. And the Silky Smooth Body Lotion from The Sanctuary. So these are my body lotions, but I usually buy a big one when I'm there. Because again, it's just such a dry climate. You need to moisturise, moisturise, moisturise. And finally, the Vita Liberata Body Blur, which Lisa, do you know what? I don't know if it's Lisa or Liza. I'm going to say Liza Prido. I will link her below. She put something on Instagram about this and said that she loved it. It's basically makeup for your legs. A bit like the Sally Hansen, but I never really got along with that. It's not dissimilar to a foundation. So if you've got an old foundation that doesn't match you or is a little bit too dark, try that, because it's probably just a cheaper version and you've already got it. But if you're looking for a fit for purpose product, this is really, really nice. It's like a tinted and slightly shimmery moisturizer, or not moisturizer. It's basically like a foundation, a product to put on your legs or your skin to perfect it. And it works really, really well. I love this stuff. So I'm taking this with me. For sure, I will only use it on my legs because it does transfer. It's not a perfect product, but if you don't want a tan, they do it in light. They only did medium where I went to Boots because I was going to get the light one. I will pick up a light one because I don't always want a tan. I hate fake tan. I'm using the Vita Liberata 3-week tan at the moment, and I'm going to do a review of that when I've had it for a little bit longer. But I hate fake tan because I hate the smell, I hate applying it, just generally don't like fake tan. But I also don't want to go on the sunbed, so, you know, lesser of two evils. But this, if you're not bothered about actually being tanned, but you want to perfect your skin, amazing, amazing, amazing. So, I think we only have brushes and nails to do. I didn't put my brushes in with my makeup because they're not dry yet, I've washed them all. But I thought I'd quickly run through the brushes that I am taking. I have two quite big ones, the Real Techniques Point XL, which is this big one. I really quite like these big ones. I don't know if you can get them in individual. I think these are Superdrug only. I don't know if you can get them in individual brushes or if you have to get the set, but these for like bronzer and stuff are a really, really nice shape. But I've got the big one because I can use it for powder and then I can use it for bronzer as well. Then I've got the Real Techniques blush brush, which I really love with my Stereo Rose for that kind of glow. I love that so much. But I'm thinking I could maybe apply my highlighter with this. People keep telling me I need a fan brush for my highlighter. We'll give it a go. This setting brush, I use this under my eyes, and sometimes I use this if I've gone crazy and I need to blend my eye makeup a little bit. Two of almost identical brushes. One is Sigma Large Shader E60, and one is the Stone Lace 941, but they're pretty much the same brush, like a flat eyeshadow brush. I'm taking this Look Fantastic brush, which has no name or number, a really thick angled brush. And I'm going to do my brows with that one. A pencil brush from Sigma, which is an E30. I kind of use that for both under my eyes smudging and that bit in the inner corner when I need just to get right in there. Perfect. This I use mostly for blending this area. Again, when I've gone a little bit mad, this is the angled blending brush from Look Good, Feel Better. That is what I use that for. And what I use for my foundation, the multitasking brush from Brushworks, really nice for cream blush as well. And the full contour shadow from Bare Minerals, you really aren't getting the full effect of any of these brushes because they're still wet, but I wanted to show you what I was taking. Lastly, nails. I'm pretty much taking my full nail kit because, number one, I was gonna have my nails gelled, and I'm so nervous to do it before a holiday because on the one hand, you wanna do it because they'll last, but then what if they don't last? You've then got to have them removed or live with chipped nail polish. I once had them done before I went on holiday. They chipped during traveling, and I had like a half a red nail the entire holiday. Kind of annoying, and so it always puts me off having my nails done with gel or shellac or whatever before a holiday. So I've done my nails at the moment with, and I'm gonna do them again before I go, but I've used the Mani Mask from Barry M, and the color is Birthday Suit. I love this because it's like dries super fast and it's matte. So I've got maybe 3 coats of that on right now. And then just on that middle finger, don't know if it's gonna focus, but just on that middle finger, I've done a little detail with one of these little strips. I've got tons of these manicure strips, but I've got a little strip there, and then I've got Northern Lights, which is this glitter from Model Zone, which is like a rose gold holographic glitter. Really, really beautiful. And just a little bit of that on that little detail there. Noisy dogs. And then over the top, of course, my Sèche Feet, which is my all-time favorite. Super, super glossy and hard-wearing top coat. And that is what I'm taking to redo these nails if I need to. Oh, I'm missing something. This, it's the Model's Own Hyper Gel in White Light, and this is what I've got on my toes. So again, to reapply, I'm taking this nail polish remover from Model's Own because it's a dip and twist one. If I need to take off the nail polish from my toes, I can always pour it out onto a tissue or whatever else I need to do. Some toe separators. I'm taking this, which might seem like overkill, but I get really, really bad, you know, little flakes around my cuticles, and they get so, so sore if you catch them. So I'm taking this with me. I'm wondering if there's a way of like fastening this up, you know, like a safety thing. Might be, but I haven't figured it out. I'm taking this with me because if I get that, then I can snip it off immediately and it never gets sore. Nail file and my Peppermint Intensive Cooling Foot Rescue, but I'm actually taking this more for my cuticles than my feet because if they get really dry, which they might, this is a wonder product. So I would say the weirdest amount of stuff that I'm taking is nails. I'm taking too much in that category, but it was that or have them gelled and then maybe be stuck with chipped nails all week, which I didn't want to do. And stuff like the moisturiser and the file and stuff like that, I think I don't know the file, but like the moisturiser, same as I said with the plain, I can kind of put it on my feet or put it around my cuticles and lay out in the sun. And it's just using that time a little bit more productively for me. So that is everything that I'm taking. If I've missed anything, it's too late to tell me, I'm afraid, because I'm already there. But hopefully I haven't. Hopefully. I tend to do these things so that I spot it for myself, but I don't think that I have. We'll see. So I'm going to pack everything up and put it in my case right now. It'll be too late. Luckily, there are loads of shops in Las Vegas. I will be posting, potentially a haul, we'll see, but I'll be posting like outfits and stuff like that. If there's anything specific you would like to see from the holiday, let me know because I will still be there by the time this goes up. So if you want any specific kind of holiday videos, and there will be vlogs on my second channel, so don't forget to go and check that out if you're even still watching because this is the longest video of all. But if you are, thank you, and I will see you guys in my next one. Bye.